Today's video is on the Industrial Revolution, just a basic introduction to the Industrial Revolution. Particularly, we're looking at Era 7, which we call 1775 to 1914. So it was really about mechanical power. There's a really big advancement and use of mechanical power, which is powering things by machines. So machines were used to produce and distribute goods on a massive scale. So they produced way more using machines than had ever been produced, and distributed way more, much further than had ever been distributed before. And it's really part of a fossil fuel revolution. So historians sometimes call it a fossil fuel revolution because the energy was now coming from coal and later petroleum. This energy ran steam engines and also electric engines. There was a big shift in laborers as well. So laborers moved from the village to the city, and you were able to really get them all working in one place. You could have a lot of laborers in one factory. And laborers are also moved from one country to another country. So the Industrial Revolution really happened to the world. Some countries manufactured things, and some countries produced the commodities or the resources that were used to manufacture. The countries didn't have much of a choice. They couldn't say, I'm not going to take part in the Industrial Revolution. It really happened to the world. When you combine the Industrial and Political Revolution, these completely changed Europe. Massive changes. And also, the rest of the world, Asia, Africa, Latin America, dealt with these changes in different ways. Some argued for the changes and the modernization and wanted those changes. But others tried to stick to the traditional ways that they knew. Japan and the United States, however, subscribed to the Industrial Revolution and had great success with it. And they became important players on the world scene, so they became very important because of the revolution and how they took part in it. It'll be interesting to see kind of how this Industrial Revolution affects things and how we eventually get to our world wars, which is what we'll be looking at after we finish up Era 7.